Rajasthan government orders an investigation. The police book the attackers but also file complaints against the victims and their families. The UP government's mega shop for distressed farmers, it waves off 30,000 crore rupees worth of loans. Meanwhile, the Maharashtra chief minister says the state is studying the UP model and will decide soon. And various states are on their way to duck the liquor ban by the Supreme Court. The Punjab government denotifies highway stretches passing through cities as city roads. Other states are expected to follow soon.
There were five people of this village who went to the cattle fair to buy cattle, and there they bought two cows because they went to buy buffaloes, but they bought cows for the fact that buffaloes were too expensive. They bought it legally, they had every papers with them, and then they were chased on the highway. They were beaten up to an extent that one person was 53-year-old Pehlu Khan. He lost his life.
भैंस ना मिलने की वजह से हमने दूध के लिए गाय ले ली सरकारी मेले से. गाय लेने के बाद में कागज बनवा लिए जो सरकारी कागज थे, उन्होंने कागज वागज की कोई नहीं मानी, कागज उसी टाइम उन्होंने फाड़ के फेंक दिए.
सबको पता है कि राजस्थान से गौ तस्करी बाहर नहीं हो सकती. तो कुछ गौ भक्त भी हैं जिनको जैसी सूचना मिलती है इस कानून के तहत रोकने का प्रयास करते हैं. रोकना तक तो कोई गुनाह नहीं है, लेकिन कानून हाथ में लेना यह अपराध.
वुड यू फॉलो द लॉ नॉट और यू अलाउ दीज विजिलेंटीज टू बिकम लॉ टू देमसेल्फ. इफ दैट इज द केस देन दे विल बी एनार्की एवरीवेयर.
दे थिंक दैट दिस इज इन द नेम ऑफ द गाउ एंड देयर इवन डेसेक्रेटिंग द काउज पायस इमेज बाय हैविंग गुंडाज लाइक दिस हैंडलिंग द सिचुएशंस एंड गोइंग अराउंड क्रिएटिंग अ लॉ एंड ऑर्डर.
ये प्राइवेट निजी आर्मी जिस तरीके से खड़ा किया गौरक्षक समिति के नाम से, अब ये वो काम क्यों कर रहे हैं जिसका जो काम है आपके संवैधानिक संस्थाओं का.
गौ हत्या के खिलाफ सब है, अगर कानून है गौ हत्या के खिलाफ तो उस कानून का पालन करना चाहिए, लेकिन शक के आधार पर अफवाह के आधार पर अगर लोगों को टारगेट किया जाए, लोगों को मारा पीटा जाए, उनकी जान ले ली जाए तो अराजकता फैल सकती है.
The law is very clear, viewers, about what you can and cannot do. You cannot stop a truck and randomly pull people out of it and beat someone to death irrespective of what your reason may be. The law is also very clear about the fact that cow slaughter is illegal, not cow transport. And whatever is illegal has a law enforcement authority to look after it. There are the police that ought to investigate and make arrests. There is the court that ought to decide who is guilty and not, and then finally decide what the punishment is. It is not random citizens on the road who get to stop people, drag them out of their trucks or their cars and beat them to death because they are offended in some way or the other, or they suspect some wrongdoing. This sort of moral policing, this sort of vigilante justice is extremely scary and also very contagious. What we have seen happen over the last few months across our country is various politicians coming out and making sweeping statements about how they want to protect the cow, which is great for them. But has it, and that's the question I'm asking this evening, has it emboldened these vigilante justice seekers to come out and do as they please? And what is even more scary is the statement from the Home Minister of Rajasthan, who's turned around and said, yes, there are people who go around looking to stop cow smuggling, and stopping is not a crime. And that emboldens those people even further. Are the sweeping statements being made by our politicians emboldening those people who go around right now moral policing and looking for vigilante justice? Who is the real criminal here? Joining me on the show this evening, Vikram Singh, former DGP of Uttar Pradesh, Sanjay Jha, national spokesperson of the Congress Party, Anila Singh, spokesperson of the BJP. Syed Abbas is a motivational speaker joining us from Bangalore. Sujay Kantawala, senior advocate in Mumbai. Shayar Khan is an Islamic scholar joining us out of Hyderabad. Rajendra Gupta, spokesperson of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad. Gaurakshya Pramukh in Mumbai will join us through the course of this conversation. I want to start with Vikram Singh and Sujay Kandawala because I like to very clearly state what the law says. Sujay Kandawala, does the law allow people to stop cars and trucks and drag them out into the street and beat them?
No, the law does not allow these people. The law stipulates that only law enforcement officers or under special category, that is your police or your others, only they who are authorized by law, they have the power to look into these aspects. If I suspect something, that something is going on somewhere, it is my duty as a citizen to immediately inform these agencies. I cannot take the law into my own hands. And looking at this, one can clearly understand this was an unlawful assembly. They were clearly premeditated. They tore the papers which were, and buying and selling cattle is a legal business. It's today I have too many cows at my farm, my personal farm. I want to send a cow to another farm of a client who wants to breed more cows. Because we kind of,
yes.
we, as
transporting,
Hindus,
transporting
no, no, as Hindus we respect,
illegal,
we respect and we worship the cow. So I want to send my cow to his farm. So now I'll be scared that I cannot send under a legal paper a cow to a friend's farm because on the way it may happen that such kind of elements may stop the truck and beat up people and kill them. So where are we going? The constitution allows a person to carry on his business. There is a protection of life and liberty. But if you are going to allow these vigilante groups to run helter-skelter and mob justice, then we are looking at very dangerous times.
And contagiously dangerous times because we're seeing this spread across the country. Vikram Singh, 200 people got together and beat up 15. There's so many things wrong with that story. If they suspected something like Sujay Kandawala rightly pointed out, they should have called the police. The police would have stopped those trucks. They would have checked the papers. And if the papers were in order, these trucks would have been safely on their way. They pulled these people out and they beat them up. Vikram Singh, these are dangerous times.
Obviously, Faye, I couldn't agree with Mr. Sujay Kandawala more. I totally agree with him in toto. It's a very dangerous precedent. And more appalling is the statement given by the Rajasthan Home Minister to say that they are at liberty to stop anyone. No one, neither you, nor me, nor anybody, nor the vigilantes have any right to stop. It is only the police, the law enforcement agencies, who under reasonable suspicion and preferably on a warrant, and if the warrant is not there, they have to, there's this procedure of writing why they want to obstruct and search without a warrant. There is a procedure laid down. I would rather that the Home Minister of Rajasthan refreshes and gets a tutorial in law before he comes out with such howlers. Now it's a very dangerous precedent. Number two, before you set about, what you can do is to inform the police, the law enforcement agencies. They will act on merits and on evidence. As Mr. Sujay Kandawala has very rightly said, trading and doing business with cattle is perfectly permissible. What is not permissible, it is for the police. Now what the police has done also opens to, it poses more questions than it answers. And indeed, Faye, it is a very scary kind of a situation. And I do hope the Rajasthan government and everybody in governance comes down heavily on those, the vigilantes and the police who did not, and in fact were marking time. One would have expected a more proactive action on the part of the police and also the administration.
Also, not Vikram Singh, not a condoned. Single arrest has been made. No arrest has been made for murder, Vikram Singh. There seems to be, and obviously, given the statement coming out of the Home Minister right now, the police are going to go soft on those people who spent an hour beating up these 15 men with no police around.
Say this was a free for all. And what the Home Minister has said gives a long rope for the cavalier attitude that the police are displaying now. Not to arrest after this public display of violence and the murder, one would have expected a more professional approach. If this has not come, I think the time has come to suspend the SO, declare rewards on the delinquents and then go after them. Because this has not happened and it is sending a very negative signal in society and all over the country. As in any case, we are not covered ourselves with glory in what happened with the Nigerians. And what we are doing now is bringing us to a lot of embarrassment and shame, and it is totally avoidable. The least we can do now is to arrest those who are guilty in the next 24 hours, suspend the station house officer for not doing his duty and ensuring proper patrolling. One hour on highway road.
We've also understood, Vikram Singh, that the police have booked the victims in this particular case as well. The police has booked the victims.
Under what?
For
under what
under the Rajasthan Bovine Act for smuggling cows. Under the Bovine Animals Act for smuggling cows. That's what these victims have been booked against. I want to bring in Anila Singh of the BJP and open up the debate to everybody here. Anila Singh, I'm very disappointed in the statement made by the Rajasthan Home Minister, and I'll play that out for our viewers in a little while, but Anila Singh, there should have been a clearer, stronger statement made by the Rajasthan government, either the Chief Minister or the Home Minister, because what's being done here is allowed a clean chit for those who did this, making it seem like it's okay.
No, the clean chit has not been given to those who have attacked this group of 15 people, and they are booked under different IPC codes. So law is going to take its own course, and definitely I agree with Vikram Singh Sahab as well that whichever government, whichever state or whoever the people are, they have to follow the law and the judicial system, and they should have the faith in judicial system of this country. I mean, I totally agree that if you are a cow vigilante, it doesn't mean that you are going to take care of the cow on the cost of human life. But definitely, those people could have stopped these people. They could have inquired where these cows were heading for.
It's not up to them to stop anybody, Anila Singh. Let me correct everybody in power in the government right now. Sujay Kantawala, can they stop people? Is a layman allowed to stop someone and check them?
If I have purchased an animal in a public auction, I have the papers which was told just now in your clipping, that victim said I had the papers, my papers were torn, then that is a crime. You can't do that. Imagine what is going to happen. Today you are looking at this incident. Imagine if you yourself buy something and someone comes and does something like that, what will
warrant?
You do?
Doesn't the police need a warrant to search someone?
No, I can understand that. I see something wrong happening. It does happen in this country. I see something wrong happening. I immediately, as a citizen, I have to inform the authority. Take the authority also over there. Cooperate. Assist the authority. But I can't take the law into my own hand just because I'm 100 people. Because this, what will happen? Jiski lati, uski vest. Just because I've got 100 people with me, I just can't run the streets amok the streets and beat up, and somebody has died. One citizen has died over here.
Absolutely. And you know, I want to point out, Sanjay Jha, I'm going to bring in Sanjay Jha here. The things that are being said that I believe are emboldening these vigilantes, things like the Chief Minister of Gujarat pointing out protection of cows is the single most important principle towards saving the whole world from both moral and spiritual degradation.
Yeah.
Another statement being made by a politician from the BJP. I had promised that I would break the hands and legs of anyone who disrespects and kills cows. Another statement from a politician in the BJP. When a cow is being killed illegally without permission, contrary to local act, the strictest punishment needs to be meted out. We should hang them by the neck from the nearest tree, Sanjay Jha. Shouldn't our political class be more responsible about statements that they're making?
Hang them. Yeah, but then they're all of faith playing into some very hardcore religious politics. Let's not, you know, beat about the bush. That's what this entire game plan is really. And, you know, you suddenly have life imprisonment in Gujarat. You have the Chief Minister of Chhattisgarh talking about we'll hang them by the neck from the tallest tree by the thinnest thread. Now, which universe are we talking about? You know, today when you read about the Alwar incident, it's a brutal attack. And as somebody rightly pointed out, it's a legitimate transaction. Now, in a democratic civil society, somebody is, you know, has a livelihood. He conducts business in a correct, transparent, official manner. And what happens? He gets killed in a mob fury. And what does the state minister say, whose job, by the way, who's taken an oath of power to say, my job is to look after every citizen of my state. He says, well, it's all right. You know, end of day, it's just a case of manhandling. And somebody is, you know, people are free. They have been given a license. It's kosher for any group to come and beat up somebody to find out whether what they're doing is correct or not. I mean, you are talking about a true banana republic being created in what is considered by many to be the world's most fascinating democracy. It's a moment of monumental shame for India. Let me tell you, Faye, you'll remember the Dadri lynching. This is reminiscent of the same. This is Dadri lynching redux. And what is happening today is, and I have to make this political point, is that this is happening at a rampant fury in the BJP ruled states, especially because they feel very emboldened by the results in Uttar Pradesh. Now, I don't know where does the BJP get this feeling that the verdict in Uttar Pradesh is a
pan-India issue, Sanjay.
To go and attack a society. I understand that. No, one minute. I understand it's a pan-India issue, but let's not try and, you know, sugarcoat a reality that is staring us in the face. You are getting statements of a very provocative kind coming from Chhattisgarh, Gujarat, a violent incident in Rajasthan. And by the way, Faye, let me tell you, the Allahabad High Court has actually made a statement today on Yogi Adityanath's government, saying that the dramatic and abrupt shutting down of the abattoirs and the slaughterhouses is denying the people the right to live, which is guaranteed to the people in a secular society as a right to live and their right to consumption habits.
Right, so Sanjeev, let me bring in Syed Abbas. Syed Abbas lives in Bangalore. Syed Abbas
has taken down a black hole.
Syed Abbas, this happened very, very far away from you. This happened in Rajasthan in Alwar. Does it make you nervous? Does it make you concerned as a citizen of India? Do you think this is reason to worry?
Absolutely, Faye. It does again, it's all coming back to, you know, the intolerant phase which we are again revisiting, which is absolutely not done. Firstly, to all those goons, I'd like to give them a round of applause for their bravery act. Hats off to you guys, that 100 of you could be able to do that to about 5 to 6 of them. What are you doing? How can you take law into your own hands? And what are you trying to do when they have legal papers to what you are doing? And especially the act of killing someone, what do you get by it? I think they should be given bravery medals. On contrary to that, the bravery medal, the best medal to them would be a capital punishment. Who are you to take the law in your hands? Are you police? Even police cannot do that. You can only arrest them. When they had all the legal papers, they had everything in right, everything in contempt. What are you trying to do? This needs a severe punishment. A severe punishment from the law, from the government of the state, Rajasthan. They need to do something so that these incidents do not take place back to back. If we, the government or this news comes for a while and shuts down, trust me, there will be many more places, many more villages across India. This would happen. Unless and until these goons are given the right way to the door or pronounce a very strict punishment, nothing can happen. If you ask me, I am nervous. I am scared with incidents like this. What if it was me or my family members who are also into meat and so on and so forth? We're transferring. This could happen to us as well. And those people, they do not fear God. They do not fear the government. They do not fear police or law. So therefore, they are the most dangerous people. Like it's known, I do not fear someone with the fear of God. I fear those who do not have fear of God, who do not fear anyone. Taking into your hands, you're going to get nothing. By killing someone that innocent, it's only going to...
Sharia Khan, do you agree with Syed Abbas? Sharia Khan, do you believe that this is reason for concern, that we should all be worried and concerned as Indians?
Yes, we should be worried as a citizens of this country. This does not augur well for the country, for the well-being of the country, for the health of the country. This is not about, this co-obsession is not about religion, I think. It's more about majoritarian politics playing out. Unfortunately, this is going to lead to social economic disruption. I don't know how it is going to help the country. What is very sad is that, you know, I see complicity of the state and the law enforcement agencies, which is extremely, you know, disturbing for minorities especially, and, you know, many people in the meat-eating population of India. You see, attacking people, lynching them on the street, this is happening especially after, like one of the panelists rightly pointed out, the far right coming to power. And I don't see how it is going to help India in any ways. And minorities feel threatened, and a lot of Dalits also feel threatened. Modi, the Prime Minister of this country, should take serious cognizance of this and do something about this. And if state is going to get involved and encourage such hooliganism, if you are going to indulge in frontier justice, you can imagine, you know, which way India is going. This is something which can't even happen, you know, what I consider a rogue nation in Pakistan. you know, we are getting Talibanized, and you know, this is such rogue nations are getting civilized, which is a travesty. I'm very saddened by what has happened. Mobs lynching a 50-year-old man. And
Anila Singh, respond to that.
Sure. So quality of voice is not very good, but still I will try my level best to participate in the debate very truthfully.
Let me repeat to you what was being said earlier. A disappointment in the complicity of the state and the law and order machinery of Rajasthan. The fact that nobody in the government has come out and made a very, very clear statement condemning this sort of behavior, that nobody in the government has come out and made a clear statement saying that this will not be tolerated and this is not the country that we live in. Why is the government, both state and center here in this case, so quiet and so complicit? What's going on?
And say, most importantly, by Section 379 of
CEF, but one word which I picked up was Talibani, something he said about Taliban. First of all, number one, India cannot become Taliban, or Rajasthan cannot become Taliban, or Uttar Pradesh cannot become Taliban. Ever.
Thank you. It can become, well, you know, if the state becomes complicit and collides and collutes with its goals, that is what India is going to become.
That's a very strong word which you are using. This is India, this is India, this is Bharat, this is Hindustan, and
Taliban is a metaphor for statelessness. Taliban is a metaphor for lawlessness.
Anila Singh, answer the question, why hasn't there been a clear statement from the state government?
Let me not debate on the word Taliban.
It is so shameful that the Home Minister does not condemn them and kinds of views are genuine.
Let me complete and let me give an explanation from BJP's point of view. Let me answer, sir. The clear action has been taken. The convicts has been booked under different IPC code, including 302. So you cannot say that action has not been taken. And before Mr. Sanjay Jha, he was saying that this episode of the unfortunate incident can be compared with Uttar Pradesh, the Dadri episode. You cannot, because let me just play out for you the bite of this. This is the media statement being made by the Rajasthan Home Minister, and
I also want to point out while we're at it that cases have been registered against the vigilantes for Section 323, voluntarily causing hurt, unlawful assembly, wrongful restraint, destruction of property, culpable homicide and theft. A murder case has been registered of 302, but I must also point out that cases have been registered against the victims and their families as well. Listen to the Rajasthan Home Minister respond to what happened.
जरूर है कि पुलिस को भी ये सूचना मिली थी कि कुछ गाड़ियों में इस प्रकार की अवैध गोल बाहर जा रही है तस्करी के लिए. पुलिस ने भी तीन गाड़ियां तो पहले ही रोक दी, कुछ गाड़ियां आगे निकल गई थी जिनको गो तस्करों ने रोक करके कुछ मारपीट हुई है. पुलिस ने सारे के सारे गाड़ियों में जितनी गोएं थी उन सबको उतार लिया है, उसको उन्होंने गौशाला को दे दिया है. ले जाने वालों के खिलाफ भी 6 मुकदमे दर्ज किए हैं, उनकी भी कार्रवाई, लेकिन जिसके साथ मारपिटाई हुई उसकी डेथ हो गई है, वो भी केस दर्ज है और पुलिस उसके लिए भी अरेस्ट करने का प्रयत्न कर रही है, उसमें भी मुलजिम नामजद है.
सर, कितना सीरियस ऑफेंस मानते हैं सर? गोरक्षा जो है, गोरक्षा के नाम पे लोग हाथ में ले लेते हैं कानून, कितना सीरियस है सर ये?
तो क्या है कि दोनों तरफ से है, जब उनको मालूम है कि राजस्थान से गो तस्करी नहीं हो सकती, कानून बना हुआ है, और पचासों बार इसकी रोज आपके द्वारा और बाकी माध्यम से सबको पता है कि राजस्थान से गो तस्करी बाहर नहीं हो सकती. हमने चौकियां 14 लगा रखी है, जहां से गो तस्करी होती है वहां भी हम रोकने का प्रयास करते हैं, फिर भी कुछ को तस्कर इतने होशियार हैं कि वो इसको ले जाने में पार हो जाते हैं. आखिर वहाँ से यहाँ तक आ गए, इसका मतलब उन्होंने लंबा रास्ता पार तो कर लिया ना. तो कुछ गोभक्त भी हैं जिनको जैसी सूचना मिलती है इस कानून के तहत रोकने का प्रयास करते हैं. रोकना तक तो कोई गुनाह नहीं है, लेकिन कानून हाथ में लेना ये अपराध है.
Well, judge, jury and executor there, Home Minister of Rajasthan, let's also play out to you what the victim said, and the victim had a completely different story to tell. Listen in.
हम पांच आदमी अपने गांव से भैंस लेने के लिए गए थे और सरकारी मेला गए थे जयपुर. वहां भैंस ना मिलने की वजह से हमने दूध के लिए गाय ले ली सरकारी मेले से. गाय लेने के बाद में कागज बनवा लिए जो सरकारी कागज थे, पुलिस ने बनवा के दिए थे. फिर उसके बाद में हमने
आपने कागज बनवाया, तो जब आपको इन लोगों ने हाईवे पे रोका, जब आप लोगों को पीछे से पीछा करके रोका, तो क्या आपने कागज दिखाया था उनको?
हाँ, मैंने उनको ले कागज दिखाया था. उन्होंने कागज वागज की कोई नहीं मानी, कागज उसी टाइम उन्होंने फाड़ के फेंक दिए.
विक्रम सिंह, व्हाट इज योर रिस्पॉन्स टू व्हाट यू जस्ट हर्ड?
See, I would like to intervene. I would like to give you just three quick points. The law minister says that the transport of the cows was illegal, najayas. The word used was najayas. Number two, he said that the vigilante have a right to obstruct. I don't know under what rules and under what law can members of the public obstruct and detain and prevent free passage of people like you and me. Number three, what the victim is saying, that he had regular papers and they were torn by the police. The police have not been able to arrest. We must learn to distinguish between the aggressor and the aggrieved. We seem to be heavily focusing our energies on the aggressors. The aggrieved has been totally left in the lurch, and we seem to be very busy registering cases and trying to put them behind bars. You seem to be putting the cart before the horse. And the law minister needs to clarify what action you intend to take against the delinquent SHO who allegedly tore the papers, number one. Number two, failed to make arrests of those who beat up the person and ultimately he died also. What action is being taken? And also, do you plan to have a dedicated team to investigate on a timely basis in the next 24 hours, 48 hours, fix responsibility of the laxity of the police department, as also the evidence against those who are the aggressors, and are you going to declare a reward for their arrest? And if not, let me assure you what action you have taken and your roadmap are far from reassuring. They do not instill any sense of confidence in your credibility, in your fair play and in your professionalism. Therefore, I would advise the Rajasthan police to declare rewards, suspend the SO and do what is expected of you in such moments of crisis.
Very well said, Sujay Kantawala. There is no confidence being built here by the government at all.
No, and to add what Mr. Vikram Singh said, I was a little taken aback by what the minister said. He said that the police had got information that there is smuggling of a huge amount of cows that is taking place, and therefore the police had advance information, but some people got away. The people that remained behind were apprehended. So if the police would have taken action, this all could have been prevented.
Yes.
Police could have seen the papers and that was it. That was the end of the matter. But police appear to have conveniently turned a blind eye, allowed this to perpetuate, and therefore I feel that just victim and offender cases is not enough. As Mr. Vikram Singh rightly said, I think it's high time to send a clear message that the concerned errant police officers also should be booked here.
Do you believe, like Anila Singh, saying enough has been done? And my concern is that the statements coming out of government have not been strong enough against this behavior. Sujay Kandawala, do you believe that the government has done enough?
No, what I feel is that what she has said, that the cases and 302, I was happy that 302, I have heard this section, I am very happy with that. But what I feel is that the state needs to be very proactive on this. Because ultimately,
no action has been taken against the police.
Absolutely.
And the police conspired in this case.
And listen,
should
whichever,
that be looked into?
Whichever religious man you belong to, whichever religion you belong to, in the eyes of the state, you are all one. It's a secular country.
Absolutely.
So therefore, the law has to be uniformly applied towards everyone. So the state, I think, has to come out, has to give out flyers, has to come out and say what is the law, and has to have a healing effect. Because otherwise, this will now come in. Now you are seeing it in Alwar. Then maybe you will see it in some other town. And this is very dangerous for the future.
In fact, you know, what Sujay Kandawala said is very, very true. Syed Abbas, irrespective of what anyone's religion is, this country is our home. This is my home. You cannot stop me from driving from one point to another. And if you want
Absolutely.
To stop me,
Absolutely.
You should call the police. This is really scary,
yes.
Syed Abbas.
Allama Iqbal in one of his beautiful poetry once said, Mazhab nahi sika tha, aapas mein pair rakhna. Hindi hai hum, Hindusta hai hamara jahan. Mostly, you know, being in a secular, democratic country, you know, we all need to coexist. There is no scope for intolerance here. Firstly, first and foremost, those goons out there hold absolutely no authority to question these people. Only a police or the government or any such official can do so. Coming to the fact that, you know, this happening, and if they are let off or something on a very, very less lighter note, these incidents, Rajasthan, Alwar, can happen in a village near Bangalore, or it could happen in Sikkim, it could happen in north, south, east, west, any part of India. There needs to be a stringent action taken, irrespective of having a laid-back attitude from the government. They need to do something about it. A person has lost his life for what? Smuggling cows? And firstly, when they had the legal papers, how is it even smuggling cows? And how can these goons take the law in their hand? This is definitely a scary incident. If the government keeps shut about it, trust me, there'll be many more Alwars all over India. And it's going to be very, very scary for all of us. If this is going to happen, trust me, many of them are going to lose their life. And this is very, very scary for being a citizen of India.
Right. Sharia Khan, I want you to respond to our next guest, Rajendra Gupta, who's joined us in the studio right now. Rajendra Gupta is the spokesperson of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad, and Rajendra Patil, I'm sorry, is the spokesperson of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad in Mumbai. Rajendra Patil ji, aap jante hain ki Alwar mein kya hua, ki Rajasthan mein kya hua, ye to kafi daravni cheez hai. Kya aapko lagta hai ki state government isse matlab bahut sakht action leni chahiye in logon ki in gaur rakshakon ki khilaf?
Ye जो कुछ घटना घटी है इसके पीछे एक तो एक्सीडेंट हो सकता है या कोई बदनामी का षड्यंत्र हो सकता है, दोनों में से एक होते हैं.
एक्सीडेंट कैसे हुआ?
एक्सीडेंट कैसे, तो जैसे किसी एक्सीडेंट, किसी ट्रक का कोई एक्सीडेंट होता है, उस समय अगर कुछ घटना घटती है तो ट्रक ड्राइवर को भी मारा पिटा जाता है. वो वहाँ का जो लोगों का जुनून है, उस तरह से लोगों का जो रोष है इसके ऊपर, इसके प्रति राजस्थान में इतना कड़ा कानून होने के बावजूद में हाउ वो इस तरह से काम करने की हिम्मत कैसे कर सकते, तो लोगों का जो रोष है, लोगों का आक्रोश है, तो उसके
कहाँ से आ रहा है ये आक्रोश, कहाँ से आ रहा है, क्यों हो रहा है ऐसा?
उनकी भावना के साथ खिलवाड़ किया जाता है.
किसकी भावना के साथ खिलवाड़?
ये जो VHP के साहब बैठ के जो बयान दे रहे हैं, इनको शर्म आनी चाहिए. ये कह रहे हैं कि आक्रोश आक्रोश है तो क्या आप सिटीजन को जान से मार देंगे? वो अगर उनके पास परमिट्स हैं तो वो परमिट दे के भी आपको लिंच करके मारेंगे आपको. आप हिंदुस्तान में हैं या पाकिस्तान में हैं? मैं यही कह रहा था कि आप तालिबान जैसे बिहेव कर रहे हैं, मेरा पॉइंट यही था. दे हैव लीगल पेपर्स विद देम, दे हैव लीगल डॉक्यूमेंट्स एंड दे आर ट्रांसपोर्टिंग कैटल विच आई बिलीव इज आल्सो लीगल इन राजस्थान.
यू कैन देम उनके पास सारे रिसीट्स, उनके पास सारे पेपर्स थे और वो गाय दूध के लिए खरीद रहे थे गाय. तो ये मतलब किसकी इमोशन की बात कर रहे हैं आप? किसकी मतलब
हैज टू टेक इमीडिएट करेक्टिव मेजर्स एंड कॉन्फिडेंस इंस्टिलिंग मेजर्स at war footing. This is going to lead to some kind of, you know, existential. We fear for our lives. We fear for our families. Who is going to give us confidence?
Sanjay Shah, look at how this case is being treated, Sanjay Shah.
No, I agree.
How can we call this an accident?
Faye, can I tell you this? I mean, this is an ugly manifestation. Whatever has happened in Rajasthan in Alwar is an ugly manifestation of, you know, the morphing of a society into a violent one, all because it is being given a religious provocation. I think until we accept the reality, we will not get a solution. The cow slaughter is banned in the majority of states in India, barring some northeastern states, and you have Kerala, West Bengal and Goa, etc. Everybody knows that. Why is it that suddenly, all of an in a very abrupt fashion, cow vigilantism and moral policing has become and ballooned into such an alarming proportion to become a threat to a common man leading his life in the most civilized way? And there is a reason behind it. Because, you know, end of day, people are being made to feel that somebody who consumes meat belongs to a religion that opposes yours. And this is a majoritarian politics in a very crude form. I mean, I can tell you, you remember when the horrific rape incident of Nirbhaya happened, the country came to a standstill. How is this different? This is also the death of an innocent man for no fault of his.
this is happening now at a, okay, in a manner.
Let's ask Rajendra Patil this question. Rajendra Patil of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad, aap bataiye.
आज हो रहा नहीं है ये तो काउ स्लॉटर बैन है केवल जो है किसी भावना भड़काने का काम करके काउ स्लॉटर का काम होता है आज भी
किसने भड़काया यहाँ पे किसने बताया
जो सोशल एलिमेंट्स है ये सब एक काम करते हैं कोई so भी please, अच्छे लोग इस काम में नहीं
करते कौन सा काम आप कौन से काम की बात कर रहे हैं
जो काउ स्लॉटरिंग के काम
दूध बेचने का काम दूध बेचने का काम कौन करता है दूध बेचने का काम कौन करता है पाटिल जी
देखिए हमने पहले किसी भी हिंसा का हमने विश्व हिंदू परिषद ने कभी समर्थन नहीं किया है हमने कहा
आप तो यहाँ पे आके यू आर गिविंग अस एक्सक्यूजेस आप बोल रहे कि शायद एक्सीडेंट था आप बोल रहे कि शायद किसी का भावना को बढ़ाया गया था
हमने उस घटना राजस्थान की घटना जो है ना एक्सीडेंट हो सकता है या किसी ने बदनामी करने की कोशिश की सकते हो दोनों में से उसकी जो रियलिटी है वो जाननी पड़ेगी राजस्थान में से
राजेंद्र पाटिल नॉट ओनली दे वॉज देयर बीटिंग अप विक्रम सिंह मारा पीटा और उसको कैमरे पे रिकॉर्ड करके उसको सोशल नेटवर्किंग पे अपलोड किया गया ये एक्सीडेंट कैसे हो सकते हैं व्हाई इज द विश्व हिंदू परिषद मेकिंग एक्सक्यूजेस
जस्ट एक्सीडेंट
आज की घटना मैं बता रहा हूँ आज सवेरे ही दो गाय से ज्यादा वो महाराष्ट्र में टोटल
ये हुआ
काउ प्रोजेनी पे बैन होने के बावजूद 27 काउ पकड़े गए
अब विक्रम सिंह की बात सुनिए विक्रम सिंह
गुप्ता जी बड़े विनम्रता के साथ केवल दो छोटे बिंदु आपके समक्ष प्रस्तुत करना चाहूंगा अगर कोई आक्रोश है वास्तविक कारणों से अगर कोई आक्रोश है वास्तविक कारणों के लिए उसके लिए पुलिस है प्रशासन है राजतंत्र है जो इसका निस्तारण विधि सम्मत तरीके से करेगा लेकिन अगर कोई आक्रोश मेरी कल्पना शक्ति से है केवल मेरी फ्लाइट ऑफ फैंटेसी से है तो उसके बारे में ये हमें सोचना पड़ेगा कि इसके बारे में कार्रवाई उस तरफ से हो जो भड़काने का प्रयास कर रहा है या जो कोई मनमाने तरीके से कानून को अपने सूक्ष्म दृष्टिकोण के आधार के ऊपर उसका निर्धारण कर रहा है और उसका अनुपालन करवा रहा है ये एक लोकतंत्र है संविधान और विधि सम्मत तरीके से देश चलता है हमारे इंटरप्रिटेशन से व्यक्तिगत या पर्सनल इंटरप्रिटेशन से नहीं चलता है हमारा ये विनम्र निवेदन रहेगा और परामर्श भी रहेगा कि अगर कोई आक्रोश है तो शासन प्रशासन पुलिस इतने सक्षम है कि उसका निराकरण विधि सम्मत तरीके से करें अन्यथा हमारे मनमाने तरीके से उसका इंटरप्रिटेशन या उसका अनुपालन नहीं हो सकता है और अगर ये कोई चीज अनुचित हुई है तो हमारा उत्तरदायित्व ये होता है कि हम उसकी भर्त्सना करें और उसकी निंदा भी करें लेकिन हम ये कहते हैं कि यह संभव हो सकता था और यह संभव होगा और तब उसके बाद हम विचार करें तो कदाचित ये एक बहुत औचित्यपूर्ण एक स्टैंड नहीं होगा
दिस वीडियो क्लिपिंग्स आर अवेलेबल एंड दे आर स्ट्रीमिंग थ्रू आउट द डे
दे आर वायरल
दे आर कंप्लीटली वायरल एंड एवरी वन आई एम ऑन सो मेनी ग्रुप सो मेनी मैसेजेस आई हैव गॉट The same video, everyone has condemned this. Everyone has condemned helpless people being beaten up. Look, first you have to show, the police has to show that there beaten was up. An illegal activity going on. There was a smuggling going on. These people said that they had the papers, they had purchased this cattle in a government auction. These government auctions are for buying and selling. They are mandis. You can buy and sell cattle all over India. So, if that is a legal activity that is being conducted, who gives these vigilantes a right to first of all stop them and then after stopping them, not only doing that, after stopping them, overpowering them and then beating them black and blue.
Mr. Jay Khatawala, I know that you have a farm yourself. Are you afraid now of killing them? On your farm?
If I want to send Mr. Patil a cow as a gift to his farm, which may be a couple of kilometers away, I am going to be shitting in my pants today because I don't know what will happen on the way. It may be a personal gift from me to him. What is wrong with that?
You know, and here's my problem. We'll take this back to Sharia Khan. This is not okay in our country. This is against the fundamental fabric that makes us who we are. This is not okay. Randomly stopping people, beating them up in the street is not okay for whatever reason. your reason then automatically is, so as soon as you resort to violence, your reason no longer counts. Your reason no longer matters. Shaya Khan.
This is, like I said, this co-obsession is nothing to do with religion. This is about majority in politics. Thousands and hundreds and hundreds and thousands of cows are dying because of drought in Karnataka and in various parts of the country. What are these vigilantes doing about that? Let me tell you, madam, that in a place called Bandipur Wildlife Sanctuary, thousands of cows died. I have supplied fodder there. We have them. That is cow raksha. Cow raksha is not beating up innocent people on the street who are transporting the cattle as per the law. Now the state government has to take prompt remedial measures to, you know, instill confidence in the minorities and even the Dalits. This communal politics is not going to lead us anywhere. It is not going to take us towards healing. This will take towards further,
Rajendra Patil is a member of the Gaur Raksha community in Mumbai. I want you to ask the question directly to him, and he speaks Hindi, about whether or not they have done enough work to save cattle from problems like the lack of water and drought, which we know Maharashtra has suffered from terribly in the last 1 year.
हमने काफी सारी छावनियां भी विश्व हिंदू परिषद की ओर से चलाई थी.
क्या किया?
जो औरंगाबाद में चलाई थी, बीड में चलाई थी, जहाँ पे जो देशी गौवंश है उनका हमने, उनके लिए हमने फ्री में छावनियां चलाई थी. और हम ठाणे में 2100 गौवंश की जो स्लॉटर्स के लिए लेके जाए थे, ऐसे छुड़ा हुए गौवंश हम लोग किए. आज तक पूरे महाराष्ट्र में लाखों गौवंश जो कटने वाले थे उसको, जो गरीब किसान है उनको दे के हमने, जो कटने वाले गौवंश उससे हमने खेती के लिए यूजफुल किया है. और इसी के साथ में गौ अनुसंधान केंद्र भी नागपुर में, अकोला में चला रहे हैं. तो हम ये सारे प्रोटेक्शन दोनों तरफ काम कर रहे हैं.
ये सब मनधड़क कहानियां है जो आप सुना रहे हैं.
आप कभी आकर देखिए, केवल देखिए, बोलने से नहीं होता है, कभी आकर देखिए.
आप आकर देखिए हमारे फार्म में
गौमूत्र से,
गाय के पानी के लिए, मरते हुए जानवरों के लिए,
गाय के
मनधड़क कहानियां बहुत सुन चुके हैं. आपके गौशाला तो विजिट कर चुके हैं.
Rajendra Patil ji, I will stop you from making statements like this on my show unless you can give me scientific evidence. Ki aapne, you found a cure for AIDS through the cow. Let's be a little realistic about the statements we are making. If you want to make a statement like that, please email me the evidence beforehand.
I
will allow you to make those statements on my show. But otherwise, I'm going to have to completely stop you.
I will email you evidence. I will email you the proof of, you know, how we are, you know, taking care of the cattle.
Hussain is on the phone line from Hyderabad. Hussain, go ahead, very quickly.
Sir, yeah, good evening.
Good evening.
मैं आपके पास जो बात हो रही है वो मैं सुन रहा हूँ.
जी
जी, लेकिन यहाँ पर सवाल सिर्फ दो है. अगर उन्हें लीगल ले जा रहा था, इलीगल ले जा रहा था, कुछ भी कर रहा हो, तो उसको तो रोकने का काम है और पुलिस को देने का काम है. पब्लिक हाथ में लेके उसको मार देने का काम थोड़ी है. जानवर के बच्चे कर दिए उसको, तो उसको के साथ तो और 5 लोग को मार दिए.
Absolutely.
कौन सा कानून है ये? कहाँ सही बोल रहे हैं कोई भी यहाँ पर बैठ के?
मुनासिब, बिल्कुल मुनासिब.
गलती किया, ठीक है. अगर लीगल नहीं है, लीगल है जो भी है, उसको जो है
What is happening is that, you know, we are facing times where we have these pockets of guys, you know, who are just waiting. You know, like you have these Twitter troll, the Twitter gangs. They are just trolling. They are just waiting for to catch somebody, and they are just waiting for some incident to happen. So this is nothing linked with religion or nothing like that. They are just gundas. These guys just need to be locked up. Their agenda is only to create violence. I can understand if you want to save an animal, you want to save a cow, there is a procedure for that. You can inform the law enforcement officer, you can tell him, you can take him to the place, you can show him that this incident is going to happen here, please take action. If he doesn't take action, then you can appeal to the higher officers.
Right.
But certainly you can't kill anyone.
You can't kill, you can't stop someone, you can't beat them, you can't do any of these things. As soon as you use violence, you become the criminal. It's very, very clear that these people are the criminals. They are the gundas. There is no two ways about it. Salim is on the phone line from Mumbai. Salim, go ahead. Salim, you have to mute your television in the background. Go ahead very quickly. I'm running out of time.
Yeah. I have a question to ask.
Yes. Go ahead, Salim.
you know, whenever they are, you know, whenever there's a movement of animals likewise in a vehicle, they're going to pull out the driver and, you know, kill him likewise?
Of all animals? What is your question exactly?
Any animal, you know, we generally see that for whenever, you know, there are animals being shifted from one place to the other, It may not be even for slaughtering, they still pull out, they, you know, they go to the extent of killing. This is not the first case which has happened in India.
Rajendra Patil ji, inka jawab de dijiye, inka puchna hai ki transport bhi galat hai? एक जगह से दूसरी जगह अगर गाय को लेके जा रहे हैं, एक फार्म से दूसरे फार्म, एक खेत से दूसरे खेत, तो वो भी इलीगल है?
देखिए, ये तो इलीगल नहीं है, इसके लिए कि कोई किसी की तरफ नहीं करता है। आज ही हम यहाँ से सीधे थाने कमिश्नर से मिलके आया हूँ।
आप इसके बारे में बात कीजिए। हाँ, इसके बारे में बात कीजिए,
इसके बारे में बात।
ये जो हम अपनी स्क्रीन पे देख रहे हैं कि ये लोगों ने,
इसीलिए लोगों का जो है वो गलत है,
हिंसा गलत है। इन्होंने क्या करनी चाहिए था?
इन्होंने लीगल तरीके से पुलिस के साथ मिलकर काम करना चाहिए था। पुलिस विल बी टेक लीगल एक्शन। इस तरह से काम करते हैं विश्व हिंदू परिषद।
अच्छा, और क्या आप मानते हैं कि ये जो हम अपनी स्क्रीन पे देख रहे हैं, जिन्होंने ये 15 लोगों को मारा, पीटा, एक को जान से मारा और उसका वीडियो निकाल के इसको सोशल नेटवर्किंग पे डाला, आप मानते हैं कि ये लोग गुंडागर्दी कर रहे हैं?
इसकी फैक्ट समझनी होगी क्या है वो?
नहीं, समझ में, मतलब आपको दिख रही है स्क्रीन पे, दिख रही है, उन लोगों ने 5 जन को मारा और एक जन से जान से मारा, ये फैक्ट क्या और क्या फैक्ट
किया है? तो गलत किया है।
नहीं, गलत किया है तो टेल मी दिस विक्रम सिंह, अगर किसी ने गलत किया है, डज दैट गिव एनी सिटीजन द राइट टू बीट देम टू डेथ?
Nobody has this right to beat it. This is always as per within the ambit of law. One of the learned panelists said, yes, all animals need to be protected and all protection will have to happen within the ambit, within the framework of law. One cannot interpret law the way I want it and beat a person to death. That is absolutely unacceptable, and the person who has done that must be booked under law, sent to jail and tried by the court of law.
So, Rajendra Patil ji, agar aapne suna, अगर आपने सुना कि विक्रम सिंह ने क्या कहा, ऐसा कोई लॉ नहीं है, कोई लॉ नहीं है जो आपको या किसी और को ये हक दे दे कि किसी को जान से मारे, आपका रीजन जो भी हो।
जी बराबर, किसी भी तरह का हिंसा का हम कभी भी समर्थन नहीं करते, लेकिन आज महाराष्ट्र में काउ
नहीं, आप बात को टाल रहे हैं। मैं ये पूछ रही हूँ कि आपने अभी जो स्क्रीन पे देखा, इन लोगों को अरेस्ट करनी चाहिए कि नहीं करनी चाहिए? गुंडा है कि नहीं है?
कोई भी गलत काम है, गलत है, हमने पहले ही कह दिया आपको,
तो आप मानते हैं? अनिला सिंह
मैडम, देखिए, देर इज अ लॉ इन गुजरात फॉर यू नो स्लॉटरिंग काउज, यू नो देयर विल बी अ लाइफ इंप्रिजनमेंट, देयर इज अ बिल हैज बीन मूव्ड, व्हाट इज द पनिशमेंट फॉर पीपल हु स्लॉटर यू नो लेजिटिमेट कैटल ट्रेडर्स?
That's a good question.
On the streets, what is the law for that? Is there an answer for that from any government?
Therefore, the government has to, they have fast track this, they have to file a charge sheet immediately, fast track this trial and bring it to its logical conclusion. We also see lot of endangered species, apart from these cows, lot of endangered are snakes and turtles and those kind of things, owls, some of these which are not allowed. There are people who are activists, but they always inform the police. They always inform the law enforcement. Look, somebody over here has got these animals. Somebody over here has got these endangered birds or fancy animals. You please come and take action. They assist the police. You cannot go around in a mob and beat somebody to death. That is not permitted. Because imagine, today you and I will be in that position someday. And what will we do? We cannot hold a stick in our hand and fight this kind of a mob. Just imagine, what is the use of all our education, all our culture? What is the use of it?
Sir, turtles and parakeets will not get them votes. It's cow, you know, they believe that the cow gets them votes. That is why all this politics is rolled around, you know, this bovine. That is the problem.
Anila Singh, is this politics at the price of emotion and lives of people of India? Because one life is lost and one life is too many, Anila Singh.
I totally agree with you, but before I answer what you have said, I just want to make one point very clear. Just now a gentleman said that cow can gather votes, but parakeets and turtles can't. So please, I would like to repeat here again that do not play with the feelings of any person about his religion. You very well understand that how cow is.
You are playing with the feelings of, you know, the people of this country, the minorities of this country. It is a joke that you are coming out with this statement, madam. Please take back, retract your statement.
You are
violating and destroying the sentiments of the minority. It is a travesty you are making on this country. Don't make a sham.
It doesn't give you right to hurt the feelings.
We revere cow like you do. We also revere cow.
You should not say this thing. Please don't say like that. I'm requesting you.
Isn't it what you have turned it into?
The logic of the fire of
cow. Don't get sentimental, Anila Singh. Don't be sensitive. Answer the question as it is.
This is the political logic.
Then I will get sentimental. Even I am a Hindu. And I am a law-abiding Hindu. I am a law-abiding Hindu.
I am a law-abiding Hindu.
I follow the constitution. I am also a law-abiding Hindu. I also respect the cow.
Vikram Singh, are you a law-abiding Hindu?
But I will not kill somebody.
I do not agree. Are you a law-abiding Hindu? I do not agree with that person. Cow is not the medium of vote for us.
I carry my animal cellular with me. What more can I say? I am a law-abiding Hindu.
Come on.
I am not going to kill anyone.
I am not going to take that.
Hey, can I come in, please? I have one simple question.
I am very, very quickly. I am going to give the last word. I think Anila Singh, you had your say. Last word to Sai Dabas, is the youngest voice on this panel. And this panel belongs to Sai Dabas.
A simple question, yes.
Yes, very quickly.
वेरी क्विकली मेरा सर एक छोटा सा सवाल है राजेंद्र पाटिल जी और अनिला जी के लिए काउ का मूल्य इतना गाय का मूल्य इतना इंसान का कोई मूल्य नहीं है इंसान की जान चले गई उसका कोई मूल्य नहीं है आपको आप इतना गाय के लिए कह रहे हैं इंसान का क्या इंसान मर गया है व्हाट अबाउट दैट फिर अनलेस अंटिल देयर आर सम स्ट्रिंजेंट एक्शंस नथिंग विल हैपन ओनली इफ अ स्ट्रिंजेंट एक्शन इज टेकन ओनली देन
Only then.
एक रौडी गुंडे उनको कुछ यू नो इनको सबको घेर के कुछ करना चाहिए नहीं तो कुछ नहीं होगा
really well said which is why we insist on having young people on this panel really well said it simply boils down to this how can your feelings and your hurt emotions whatever they were hurt for be more important than the life of another citizen of this country If you were offended, if you were hurt, if you were upset about some way, talk about it, write about it, complain about it, call the police about it. It does not give anybody the right to take a life, to resort to violence. And let me point out very clearly, our religion does not matter in this country. To the constitution of this country, we are all the same. All our lives are important. Nothing and nobody gives you the right. Not in this country, not in my country, nobody gives you the right to just march up to whoever you please and resort to violence and take a life because you suspect wrongdoing, because your feelings have been hurt. If your feelings have been hurt, the law gives you various methods to deal with that problem. And violence, my dear friends, is not one of them. It is not going to be okay in this country and we are not going to put up with it. And if the government doesn't make a strong enough statement about it, we are going to. This is not acceptable, not in today's India. That's very clear. Thanks for watching.
Presented by